Hallelujah, God.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah, God. God, we thank you, God. Thank you, God, for waking us up early this morning, God. Thank you, God, for us being clothed in our right minds, God. Thank you, God, for ample movement of our limbs, God. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the breath you breathe into our bodies, God. Thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you're going to allow to come forth on this day, God,
yes,
on this week, God.
Yes,
Lord,
Father.
We thank you, Lord, for the testimonies that's coming out of this, God.
Yes,
Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the pruning place, God. We thank you, Lord, for the testing place, God.
Yes, Jesus.
God, we thank you, Lord, for being in our right minds,
yes,
God. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for being in good spirit, God.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord, for lifting up our heads, God.
Thank
you, Lord, for keeping your arms around us,
yes,
God.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord, for talking with us, God, walking with
yes,
us, God, speaking to us, God. Keep continuing to pour into us, God. God, I ask that you forgive us for every sin, God.
God,
one's known
God.
And one's unknown,
yes,
God.
Father.
God, I ask that you continue to push us past our own expectations,
yes,
God.
God.
God, I ask that you stand up in all of our lives, God.
God,
every
God.
Family tied to this ministry, God.
Jesus.
Continue to push us, God. Continue to press us, God. Continue to allow people to see the God in you in us, God.
Yes,
Lord
God.
Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for us being examples, God.
God.
Living our lives accordingly, God. Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for who you are, God.
Yes.
Lord Jesus, sit me down, God. Sit all of us down, God,
yes,
and stand up in us, God.
Yes.
Lord Jesus, you can have thine own way with
yes,
me, God.
Yes.
Have your way in our families, God.
Yes.
Have your way on our jobs, God. Lord Jesus, have thine own way in our lives, God.
Yes.
Lord Jesus, we ask that you shift this atmosphere on tonight, God.
Yes.
We ask that you come in, God, and sit your glory on us,
yes,
God. Lord Jesus, stand up in us, God.
Jesus.
Lord Jesus, move Shayla out of the way, God, and
yes,
speak through me, God.
Lord
Jesus, I ask that you speak through me, God.
Yes,
say what,
God.
So I can say what you will have me to say, God.
Yes.
So that I can do what you will have me to do, God.
God.
Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for the tests and trials on this
yes,
week, God.
God.
Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for the tests and trials on this
Jesus.
Week, God. Lord Jesus, you get all the glory, God. You get
yes,
all the honor, God. And you get all the praise,
yes,
God.
Father.
Lord Jesus, I'm expecting you to move and have your own way, God.
Yes.
I'm expecting you to move, God. I'm expecting
yes,
you to do exactly what you said
God.
You would
yes,
do, God.
Father.
I'm expecting for you to pour into us, God.
Yes.
I'm expecting for you to save our lives, God.
Yes.
I'm expecting for you to heal us, God. I'm expecting
yes,
for you to deliver us, God.
God.
I'm expecting for you to set us free, God.
God.
I'm expecting for you to wash us, God.
Yes.
Pure as snow, God. Continue to cleanse us, God.
Yes.
For the crown of our heads, God, to the sole of our feet, God. Lord Jesus, cleanse us now, God. Purify us now, God. Have thine own way in our lives,
God.
Lord Jesus, I ask that you shift me now, God. Shift this atmosphere, God, and have thine own way, God. Have thine own way in our lives, God. Have thine own way in this Bible study,
God.
Have thine own way in our jobs,
God.
Have thine own way in our lives, God. In our household, God.
Jesus.
Lord Jesus, I ask that you come through like a mighty rushing wind,
yes,
God.
God.
Come through like a mighty rushing wind, God.
Yes,
sit on us, God, like never before, God.
Yes,
sit on us like
yes,
never before,
Father.
God.
In the name
God,
of
I
Jesus.
Ask that you sit on me like never before, God.
Yes.
Lord Jesus, allow me to keep driving, God, to keep
yes,
pushing, God,
yes,
to keep speaking goodness, God, to keep speaking positivity, God.
Yes.
Have your way, God.
Yes.
Have
yes,
thine own way, God. Lord Jesus, I ask that you continue to speak, God. Continue to pour in us,
God.
Continue to pour in us, God. Have your way, God.
Have
your way, God. You get all the glory, God. You get all the honor, God.
Yes, Jesus.
God, you get all the praise, God. Lord, we worship your name, God.
Yes, Father.
You're so worthy to be praised,
God.
Lord, you're so worthy to be praised,
God.
You're so worthy to be praised, God. Hallelujah. You're so worthy to be praised, God. Hallelujah. You're so worthy to be praised, God. Lord, we bless your name on tonight, God. We bless you for who you are,
God.
We bless you for all the ways that you made, God. We bless you for all the doors that you opened,
God.
We bless you for all the ways that you provided,
God.
We bless you for waking us up this morning, God. We bless your name for clothing us in our right minds, God. Lord, we bless your name for keeping us in good spirit, God. Lord, we bless your name for saving us from accidents, God. We bless your name for getting us torn from all our destinies.
Yes, God. In the name
Lord, we
of
bless
Jesus.
Your name for who you are, God.
Yes.
We bless your name for healing us, God.
Yes,
we bless your name for saving us,
come
God.
On.
We bless your name for purifying us, God. Lord, we bless your name for who you are, God. We bless your name for cleansing us, God. We bless your name for walking with us, God. We bless your name for talking with us, God. We bless your name for being strong, God. We bless your name for being God.
Yes, God.
Bless your name for the doors that you're opening for our families, yes, God. Lord. Bless your name for the testimonies that's coming from this ministry, God. Bless your name for our pastor, God. Bless your name for every good leader, God. Lord, we bless your name for every word poured into our lives, God. Lord, we bless your name, God. Lord, you're so worthy to be praised, God. You're so worthy to be praised, God. You're so worthy to be praised, God. We have so much to bless your name for, God. Lord, I bless your name for being in good health, God. We bless your name for wealth, God. We bless your name for healing, God. Lord, we thank you now, God. We ask that you hear our prayers, God. Hear our prayers, God. Hear our prayers, God. Lord, we ask that you hear our prayers, God. Have thine own way in our lives, God. Come through like never before, God. Lord, we need you to come through, God. We need you to come through, God. Lord, we need you to come through, God. Have your way, God.
Have your way, Father.
Have thine own way, God.
Have your way, Father.
Have thine own way, God.
Have your way, Father.
Trusting God. We believe it and we're trusting you, God. In your son Jesus' name we pray, God. We give thanks and count it done, God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. We thank the Lord. We thank God for what he's doing. What he's doing on tonight. We give God all the praise and all the glory. For it is in him that we live and move and have our very being. We thank the Lord for how he anointed and moved Sister Shayla on tonight and allowed her to pray and break down walls of barriers and to be able to press into the anointing that's on her life. Amen.
Amen.
On tonight, I want us I always like to go back over the lesson that I preached on this past Sunday so we can always get a better understanding of what it is that the Lord is speaking. Because sometimes when the Holy Spirit begins to flow, sometimes we don't begin to teach everything that we wanted to go over so you can get a better understanding. And I like for our people to be able to not only to celebrate in the Word of God and to praise and worship, I also like for us to be able to have a clarity or understanding of what the Word is really saying. Because oftentimes people get hyped up. And when the enemy comes in, we can dance and we can praise and all that stuff, but he'll wait on you to finish because he know that you don't have no Word in you. And it's the Word that's going to activate the power that's on the inside of you. The Word to activate the power that's on the inside of you.
That's right.
So what was the title of our message on this past Sunday?
What's happens in you is worth following.
Yes, what's in you is worth following. And do all of us know that all of us are called to lead in something?
Yes.
All of us are called to lead in something. All of us are not called to lead in everything. And I was telling y'all on this past Sunday, I remember growing up that one thing that our parents always told us that you got to be a leader and not a follower. And that sometimes that we listen to that and we automatically think following is not good. And that following is a bad thing, but we have to understand that it's okay to follow somebody, even leading, that you at some point that you got to know how to follow somebody. That even leading and walking in the thing that God has spoken over your life sometimes means that you're going to have to follow behind somebody else that has done the same thing that you're trying to do.
Yeah.
That you got to be not only follow, that you got to be a good follower and have to understand that sometimes in order for me to get to where I'm going and to be able to lead with what's on the inside of me, I first got to be a good steward. I first got to sit down and be able to listen to somebody, allow somebody to teach something to me, instill something to me, and now I allow that to be cultivated, and now I can take what's on the inside of me and lead the people that are following me.
Yeah.
And see, the thing of the matter is, yes, I am the pastor of this church, and all of y'all that's sitting in the congregation, what are y'all doing?
Following.
Following. Is that a bad thing?
No.
No. And when somebody is leading a song and the background is doing what?
Following.
Is that a bad thing? No, because everybody can't lead every song. And we think that just because we can sing, that automatically that we can lead every song that's out there to lead, and we can't do it.
Yeah.
There are some people that better at traditional songs.
Right.
There's some people that can bust down a Yolanda Adams. But don't come up there with no voice like Rance and then think that you're going to be able to do something and think that you're going to be able to sing. Come on now. And just because Kirk Franklin know how to teach the music, he can't sing it himself. But he got an ear to be able to know that he can pick up on your voices. He know how to be able to put the song together. He know how to compose it. He know how to write it. He know what best fits Tamela. He know what best fits David.
Yeah.
And he put them in position. Excuse me. He put them in a position and allowed them to be able to now lead it.
Yeah.
But you got to understand that every vision that God give you, that going to be people that going to have to follow behind it.
Yeah.
A vision cannot stand if you don't have somebody helping you push it through.
That's right.
Even though God gave me the vision for divine destiny and I'm leading it, the truth of the matter is I can't do divine destiny by myself.
Amen.
I can't do Daughters of Zion by myself. I can't do Beautiful You Salon by myself. Because guess what? If I ain't got no clients, guess what's going to happen?
It ain't no beauty for you.
If I don't have no numbers, there ain't going to be no what? Divine destiny. It takes followers to be able to help push out the thing that God has placed on the inside of you. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to say, what's in me?
What's in me
is worth following.
Is worth following.
I don't care.
I don't care
what you have.
What you have.
I know.
I know
what I possess.
What I possess.
And what I have.
And what I have.
I know it's good.
I know it's good.
Come on now.
Amen.
What I got is good. The thing of the matter is, we mess up because we think that we all got to do it the same way.
Yeah.
That's true.
That you can even see people that's grooming little kids to be preachers, what they start teaching them. And the truth of the matter is, that's something sometimes people just pick up and they start doing. It not necessarily mean that that's the way that a preacher got to preach.
That's right.
But people get in a habit or seeing people do something the same way and automatically they think that that's right.
Yeah.
And we have to understand that we have to lead the way that God has called us to do it.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That I was listening to somebody just on yesterday, and they was talking about you doing this and you doing that. Yes, I'm following the instructions that God has given me.
Come on. Yeah.
And being a good leader, first you got to know what God has spoken on you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
What God told you to do. Because if not, and we're going to get down. I'm so ready to get in the gift class. I don't know what to do. I'm telling you, there's going to be some good nuggets coming out of that.
Come on.
But let me tell you something. Being a good leader, first you got to be a good listener.
Come on.
What did God speak and say to you? Because if you waver off of what he said to you, guess what? You will start following behind everything that everybody else mm-hmm. is speaking over you, and you will be all over the place.
Jesus.
I don't know which way to go. I know. I think the Lord told me. I believe the Lord said. And we'll start being all over the place.
Amen.
And then when this wind begin to blow, then you'll start following behind them. And when another wind to blow, and then you see that train on fire,
yeah.
you say, you know what? I'm going to go follow them. Choo, choo, choo. And then you're going to run over here. And you all over the place.
Yeah.
And people can't follow you. They be like, well, dog, I thought she did uh-huh. have.
Mm-hmm.
Now all of a sudden, she a mechanic. Now she done gone from being a mechanic, now she a makeup artist. Now she gone from a makeup artist, now she a cook. Now she gone from a cook, now she over here writing books. Then she then went from writing books, now she doing something else. Come on.
Amen.
What has God called you to do?
That's right.
And not to say that when God called us to do a thing, that things won't begin to flow together. Because in Genesis, the stream began to flow, and it flowed into one. And no, the one stream, it flowed, and it flowed out to several different streams.
Okay.
God going to give you multiple streams of income.
Yeah.
But guess what? You ain't going to be all over the place.
Please. Come on.
Yes.
Amen.
Because I'm telling you right now, I don't want you out there changing no tires and then coming in and talking about you mixing up no cake batter for me.
I ain't
nothing but a little good. I want no dry cake,
but I ain't want that kind of oil in it. Okay, you got to know what God has called you to do. And it makes it hard for people to follow you when you're not sure of what God told you to do. They be like, now, I was following you. You were doing good over here. And now you done started doing something else. Nah, you doing too much.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Now you selling insurance. Mm-hmm. Now you on weight control. Then you over here, now you're baking cookies. Come on. Mm-hmm. And all over the place. I think somebody set the door. And we doing too much.
No, not like that.
And it makes it hard to follow.
Yeah.
So I want us to say, what's in me?
What's in me
is worth following.
It's worth following.
What's in me
is worth.
Is worth following.
Following.
What I have.
What I have.
I know. I'm called to lead it.
I'm called to lead it.
Come on, you a leader. You a leader, but you also a good follower.
Yeah.
You a leader, but you're also a good follower. Because if Wanda can sing a whole lot better than me, I don't mind backgrounding her.
Amen.
Why? Because she can lead in that.
Yeah.
Bree can lead in worship. I don't mind following her. What we doing on Sunday morning? We following them as they lead us into worship.
Yeah.
If Bianca and Shayla are good ushers at the door, I don't mind coming up here to do what I'm called to do. Because one thing about it, you got to be able to trust the people that you, the assignment that you have given them.
Yeah.
When you trust the assignment that's given to them, it makes you able to flow better in the thing that God has called you to do. If I have a shampoo girl and I'm back there trying to tell her, now you got to put the shampoo on here, you got to rinse, and then you got to rinse that out, and you got to do this, and I got to keep constantly going back around there to do that, and then I got to make sure she didn't did this and did that. Guess what? I can't effectively now do my job.
Yeah.
Because not only am I micromanaging your job, I'm also doing my job, and guess what? Now I'm not able to get the job done.
Right.
And now I'm getting backed up. Why? Because I'm trying to do too much.
Amen.
What God has called us to lead in, we can't be afraid to be able to walk in it.
Yeah.
Okay, I want us to go to the book of Ruth. A follower is, thank you, Sister Bianca. A follower is, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing this word right, an adherent, A-D-H-E-R-E-N-T, or a devotee, of a particular person, cause, or activity. When I'm following you, I believe in who you are first. In order for me to follow you, I first got to first believe in you.
Right.
Yeah.
People ain't following you if they don't even believe in you.
That's right.
I don't care what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You can make the best designer jeans. You can make the best cakes, cookies, rice pudding. I don't care what you're doing. If people don't believe in you, they ain't gonna buy it.
Amen.
You can have the best bob. You can have the best shoe. You can have the best clothes, outfits, and they know that you're good at it. But if people don't believe in you, they're not going to invest their money in you.
Exactly.
They have to also believe in your cause. What are you standing for? Mm-hmm. I was teaching in, I think it was Rain Daughter. I said that you got to be your own billboard.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is your cause? And you got to be able to make it believable for people to be able to follow behind what you believe in. If you don't believe in what you're selling, I ain't going to believe in it.
That's right.
So when I get up and come to Divine Destiny, I'm on time. Mm-hmm. I'm consistent with it. When you're not consistent in doing something, people ain't going to follow it.
Right.
I can guarantee you there are people that when I stepped out to do Divine Destiny, they was already saying it ain't going to last.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Because people sit back and wait first, is it consistent?
Right.
Yeah.
But I already knew it was going to make it. They the ones that said I wasn't, they don't know me. Because I don't quit easily.
That's
I don't start something and then I walk away from it.
Right.
You got to also believe in the activity. You think that people don't join the lives and watch the activity of what's going on? Because first of all, I want to be able to believe in what they're over there doing.
Mm-hmm.
In case I want to join it. If they don't believe in you, they don't believe in your cause, and they don't believe in your activity, they ain't going to be no follower of what you're trying to do.
Come on.
Amen.
The second definition of follower is a person who moves or travels behind someone or something. Didn't y'all move?
Mm-hmm.
Didn't y'all travel for this?
Yes, girl.
Come on now.
Yes, ma'am.
Ain't it taking you someplace?
Amen.
When you following something, it got to take you somewhere. If it ain't taking you nowhere, what you following it for?
Yeah.
If it ain't doing that for you, what you running behind something for that ain't working for you? So when you're following someone, not only do you have to believe in the person, you have to believe in what they believe in.
Amen.
Okay, let's go to the book of Ruth. I know my reader is not here tonight, but who's going to be my reader on tonight? The book of Ruth is set during the time of Judges. I want somebody to read the first chapter of Ruth. Just read the first and the second verse for me.
One says, now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. And the name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife, Naomi, and the name of his two sons, Mahlon and Chilion. Ephrathites of Bethlehem, Judah, and they came into the country of Moab and continued there.
Okay, okay. Bethlehem means house of bread. House of bread. Bethlehem was going through a famine. What is a famine? Lack of resources. It dried up, right?
Yeah.
And Bethlehem was the house of bread. Okay, Amalek. He intended to leave and go to where he was going temporarily. I want to be able to show y'all two different ways of when you got to make sure you know that you're following the right person. Okay? Because when you follow the wrong people, I'm going to give you the first way of how things are happening when you follow the wrong people. Amalek left the house of bread to go to Moab. And he took his family to Moab with them. Guess what his family was doing? They was what?
Following
him. Yeah. They followed him somewhere because why? A lot of times people believe in the head of the household.
Right.
Yeah. They believe in the one that's leading them. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, they probably didn't question it at all.
Right.
Daddy said, we going. So all of us going to pack up and we going. So Amalek took his wife and his children along with him. Amalek name meant God. God is, my God is king. His name meant my God is king. He left from a place called the house of bread to go to Moab, and they were pagan people. They did not even believe in God. My God is king, but I'm going to a place that don't even believe in my king. Don't even believe my God is king. And he left a place called the house of bread to go to some place that he thought was better. Oftentimes we are run to go someplace because we think the grass is greener on the other side. And we don't wait for what we have prayed for or what we are believing for. We don't wait on it. We hurry up and run from it because we don't like pain.
Come on.
We don't like when things don't go the way that we thought that it should. We don't like when God don't move when we ask God to move and he take his own sweet time. So now we'll start saying, I'll take matters in my own hand. Let me pack up my family and let us go. God is taking too long to answer my prayer. I'm tired of leaving. I'm trying to pay Paul, robbing Paul to pay Peter. I'm tired of working from paycheck to paycheck.
Yeah.
I'm tired of getting up every day believing you're going to move, God. Yeah. You ain't did that with the supervisor yet. Mm-hmm. You ain't did that with my boss yet.
Yeah.
So, God, now I got to move because you ain't moving fast enough.
Yeah.
So he went to a place instead of using his name. Using the power that rests on him and begin to declare a thing. God, the Bible said, whatsoever you declare, it shall be established upon the earth.
Yeah.
You got the power on the inside of your mouth to be able to change your situation.
Come on. Yeah.
In the midst of a pandemic, how many of y'all prospering?
Come on. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, God.
In the middle of a pandemic. pandemic, I still see people getting houses. I still see people getting cars. They didn't say, you know what, I'm going to move and go someplace else. Because guess what? The pandemic is all over the world. So either you're going to trust God or die. He chose to leave. And sometimes you think that you're running from your problems. And you end up running into something worse than what you left. And sometimes God is saying, stay there and trust me. Amalek name, my God is king, signifying a devout commitment to the God of Israel. His wife name, Naomi, meant pleasant. Milan name meant sick. And Chilean name meant penning. I want you to read Ruth, the third verse for me.
And Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died. And she was
left. Elimelech what?
Died.
Now, the last verse, he just left.
Mm-hmm.
He
just left.
So you have to be mindful of how you move your feet.
Come on.
Because what you think you're running from, you actually run into the trouble when you move off of your own understanding.
Come on.
How you leave from the second verse saying that they were packing up to leave, and as soon as he get there, eliminate, die.
Go.
Finish third verse.
And she was left and her two sons.
And he.
Elimelech died. And let me tell you something. During that time, a woman didn't seem like they had anything once they did not have a husband.
Yeah.
It was like they had no value. No nothing. And here she was left with two sons. Now, after studying on today, I realized that his children must have not gotten married to the women until after the husband died. Then they married two women that was not even of their same faith. Because they married two women from Moab. Read the fourth verse.
And they took them wives of the women of Moab.
Didn't I just say that?
Yeah.
The name of the one was
Orpha.
And the name of the other, Ruth. And they dwelled there about 10 years.
They were there not even 10 years before the daddy died. And then after being there almost about 10 years, now they got married. Okay? You have to be mindful of who you get married to. Because everybody don't believe like you believe.
Amen.
That's why the Bible talks about not being unequally yoked. Because it's hard to fight by yourself. And but when you're trying to fight with somebody that's pulling in the other direction, it becomes harder because they don't believe like how you believe. Read the next verse.
And Milan and Chilion died also, both of
my God. Mm-hmm. Come on now. And what verse we in?
Verse 5.
The first two verses talk about the daddy died.
Mm-hmm.
Now we ain't even in the fifth verse yet, and now the sons died.
Mm-hmm.
And they followed who?
The daddy.
Yeah. And now all of them died. Go ahead.
And the woman was left of her two sons, and her husband.
No. Orpha name means stubborn. And Ruth name means friendship. You'll be able to understand both of their names as we continue to go down in the chapter a little bit more. It'll understand why their names meant what it meant. Okay? Read the next verse for me.
Then she arose with her daughters-in-law that she might return from the country of Moab. For she had heard in the country of Moab how that the Lord had visited his people and given them bread.
Okay, now she heard in the sixth verse that after she then lost her husband and lost her sons, See, it's showing right here if you just wait a little while. Mm-hmm. They didn't wait long, and they went over someplace and they died. Sometimes that we get in a hurry because it looks like it's better to where we're going, and we'll jump on it and we'll run with it. Yeah. And sometimes if we just wait on God, have we ever prayed for something? I know I ain't the only one. And when you jumped up to do it on your own, and all of a sudden it began to work out, and you be like, dog, why did I jump out here and do this? Yeah. If we be patient and wait on God, and wait on what we prayed on, if we just wait a little while, we'll see how God begins to unfold the things. Yeah. If we just take the time to wait. We now just in the sixth verse. Yeah. And they bailed out before God's hand began to move. Sometimes we think when God's hand don't move when we want it to move, we think God ain't moving. But sometimes it's not that God is trying to do the miracle there. Sometimes God trying to do the miracle in you.
Yes.
I want to build your faith.
Yeah.
I want to teach you how to praise. I want to teach you how to praise me. I want to teach you how to worship. Yeah. Because sometimes we got to allow ourselves to go through something in order to teach us how to pray. How many of us, we got our best prayers out when we started going through something?
Yeah.
We got our best praise, our best worship when we was going through something. And God knows how to get the very best out of us.
Yeah.
Okay, read the seventh verse.
Wherefore she went forth out of the place where she was, and her two daughters-in-law with her. And they went on the way to return unto the land of Judah.
Right here, they begin to, now they going back to Judah. What does Judah mean? Praise.
Yeah.
Judah means praise. Okay. In the middle of your transition, I want y'all to know that you cannot forget your praise.
Amen. Right.
Because the Bible tells us that we got to give the spirit of heaviness, that God would give us the praise, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That we got to understand that sometimes even when we heavy, even when we weighty, that sometimes that we got to begin to praise our way through. Oftentimes when we go through, people begin to sit home. I ain't going to church.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
I ain't going to praise. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like it. I ain't going. Because you feel like you mad at God, and I ain't going to praise him because of what I'm going through. And in the place that Naomi lost her husband and her children, I'm sure that she was hurt.
Yeah.
Well, she ended up finding herself back in the place of Judah, which meant praise. Mm-hmm. God wants us to be able to be able to still praise him in the midst of what we're going through.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
How many of us are going through something in the room?
Yeah.
Amen.
How many of you can still praise him in the middle of it?
Amen.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to push yourself to praise even when you don't feel like it. Sometimes you got to push yourself into a place of praise, because if you don't, you will fall in a place of being depressed, oppressed. You will find yourself to be up here talking about you're about to lose your mind and all kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And you'll begin to lock up with people and start having pity parties.
Yeah.
And people will be quick to get on a post in a minute. Soon as somebody talk about tears. Going through. And they'll jump on that.
Yep.
But come on, how many of us can start a praise party?
Yes.
How many of us can continue to praise God in spite of what we're going through?
Yes.
You know, just on today, I started walking. I got out of my car. I said, God, I need to meet you. I got out my car and I just started walking around the park. God, I need to meet you in the place that I'm in right now.
Yeah. Jesus.
Thank you, God. And then started talking to him. And you know, the more I started walking, the better I started feeling.
Yeah.
And then God was able to give me instructions.
Come on.
He started being able to comfort my heart.
Yeah.
But when you get in a place that you're sitting around thinking about, oh, this ain't working out.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't going the way I thought it should.
Mm-hmm.
My dog died.
Mm-hmm.
The cat died.
Mm-hmm.
French fries and burn up. And we start thinking about everything that went wrong.
Yeah.
Gotta make y'all laugh a little bit. Sometimes you start thinking about everything that ain't going right.
Yeah.
But if you just start taking a moment and say, but you know what, God?
Yeah.
In the middle of a pandemic, God, when coronavirus is going all around me, God, I'm still here. In the middle of a pandemic, God, that God that you still blessing me. My light's still on. I still got food on the table. I still got a job to go to. God, I'm still in my right mind. I still got health and strength. My mama alive. My daddy alive. I still got a car to drive. I go to bed at night. Got water to run before I get into bed. You got to tell God, thank you.
Yes.
Somebody put on a post earlier today, and it's an old song. Hawkins made it, and it could have been me.
Oh yeah, I love it.
I don't care how old that song get. That always my jam. When they start playing that thing, come on now, always. You got to always tell him thank you. Naomi found herself in a place that she still had to get to, a place of praise.
Yeah.
That we can't just start running and wait till God's hands start moving. Sometimes a walking in a place of faith, I got to move and praise God before I see his hand move.
Yeah.
Because I got that much faith in him. I trust you, Lord. Trusting God is not waiting on him to move.
Come on.
Trusting God is I can still go off of what you said and believe by the time I get there, it's already done.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, gotta praise him in the hallway till the door open up.
Yes,
come on now.
Yes. Yes, God.
My God.
Yes.
Ruth 1:8.
And Naomi said unto her two daughters-in-law, go, return each to her mother's house. Mm-hmm. The Lord deal kindly with you as ye have dealt with the dead and with me.
She was telling them, you know what, y'all did good by me.
Yeah.
She was blessing them, actually. Y'all did good by me and my sons.
Mm-hmm.
So I pray that God bless you on whatever you're doing.
Yeah.
I pray that the hand of God continue to go with you. See, you know what? Sometimes I go to bed and I get good rest. Not sometimes, I get good rest when I go to bed. You know why? Because I do right by folk.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you do good by folk, guess what? You know good gonna come back to you.
Yeah.
I don't beat my conscience wrong when I ride by people.
Mm-mm.
You over there mad because you want to be mad. Guess what? I got good rest when I go to bed at night because I know I did right.
Yes.
Come on.
Come on. And she was blessing them. She said, in spite of what we're going through right now, I bid y'all to go on ahead.
Yes,
I pray that God bless you and cover you wherever you're going because y'all did right by me and the dead.
Yeah.
You got to understand that sometimes that you got to know what you're doing and you're doing it for the right reasons.
That's right.
How did they know that those boys was going to die that soon?
Mm-hmm.
But in spite of, guess what? I can't be held accountable for how your heart is.
Come on.
Because I know how my heart is.
My Lord.
And I'm going to be judged according to my heart, not yours.
Mm-hmm.
Read Ruth 1:9.
The Lord grant you that ye may find rest, each of you in the house of her husband.
Find rest, y'all. Y'all ain't resting at night.
Jesus.
We go to sleep, but we ain't resting. You got to start resting at night.
Yeah.
Resting on the fact that you're doing what God has spoken and called for you to do.
Amen.
If you ain't resting at night, that because you ain't doing what God has spoken and told you to do.
That's right.
I know when I wouldn't walk forth in divine destiny, I wasn't sleeping at night.
Yeah.
I told God, I ain't doing it. God ain't doing that. He said, okay. Yeah, we'll see.
We'll see the man that pulled your ass.
And until you do what he told you to do, I'm telling you right now, you ain't going to get no rest.
Amen.
You're right.
When you out of position, I'm telling you right now, you ain't going to get no rest at night. God will ride you all night.
Yes, sir.
Deal with you in your subconscious.
Yeah.
And you wake up, God, I'm tired. I didn't went to bed at 7:00 and I'm still tired. Do what God told you to do and he'll give you rest.
Yeah.
Read on.
Then she kissed them and they lift up their voice and wept.
Okay.
And then you can continue to stand if you want to. Actually, you can sit down. You ain't got to stand up and read. And she released a blessing over their future and their marriage. She was telling them, even when you going forward, I pray that the men that find you or whatever, that you have a good marriage, a good life up ahead of you.
Right.
Because of what you have gave me. I want to make sure that you're covered in all areas. Right. You know, some people, they so dirty and grimy. They know that you did right by them. And when it's time for you to move on, they don't even want to bless you.
Yeah.
They want to keep you tied to them.
Come on, come on. It's true. You're right.
I'm bitter. I'm mad. I'm angry. Yeah. So I'm going to keep you tied to me so that you don't go nowhere.
Right.
Even in her place of being hurt, she still said, I bid you goodbye. Yeah. And I'm going to bless you as you go on.
Right.
We don't have no ownership over people.
That's
right. The truth of the matter is, everybody ain't gonna be with everybody always.
Right.
There's gonna be some people that get on the elevator with you, but guess what? Everybody ain't gonna go to the top floor with you. There's some people gonna get off on the third floor.
That's right.
But when they ride is over, I bid you goodbye.
Yeah.
I pray that God bless you in all that you do. But our time is up.
Amen.
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 Read on to the 10th.
And they said unto her, surely we will return with thee unto thy people.
And they were still telling her, no, we ain't leaving you.
Yeah.
Because Ruth name means friendship.
Yeah.
And Orpha names means stubborn. Right. And they were saying, no, we ain't leaving you. We gonna ride with this. But let me show you how quick, when things don't move as quick as you think that it should, you will find people that start off with you won't stay with you.
Come on.
When things don't begin to turn like how they thought it should, they'll be like, you know what? I ain't down for this. I done been through enough. I'ma just go ahead and turn on back now because I don't know what we about to run into.
Mm-hmm.
When people don't see the real call and anointing that's on your life, they'll quit the bail out.
Mm-hmm.
When people don't see their own value, you know they won't see the value in you.
Right.
Okay, read 11 through 13.
And Naomi said, turn again, my daughters. Why will you go with me? Are there yet any more sons in my womb that they may be your husbands? Turn again, my daughters. Go your way, for I am too old to have an husband. If I should say I have hope, if I should have and husband also tonight, and should also bear sons. Will ye tarry for them till they were grown? Will ye stay for them from having husbands? Nay, my daughters, for it grieveth me much for your sakes that the hand of the Lord is gone out against me.
All right, that's the 13th verse. Okay, we got to understand sometimes when God deals with us differently, we tend to think he's against us instead of him pushing us.
Yeah.
That she said that the hand of God was against her. That sometimes God is actually pushing you.
Yeah.
Pushing you to move forward. And even though that they followed Elimelech where they followed him to Moab, and even though they died, sometimes it takes people dying for God to raise up on the inside of you. Because now we're leaving from following Elimelech, and now we're going to follow Ruth. Follow Naomi. And you got to understand that sometimes it takes things, relationships to sever. Sometimes it takes a breaking up. Sometimes it takes people dying. Isaiah said, I didn't see the Lord high and lifted up till King Uzziah died. Then I saw the glory of the Lord fill the room. Sometimes it takes things dying, people walking away from you, people turning their backs on you, in order for the God that's on the inside of you to be able to stand up and raise up, for you to go forth in the thing that God has spoken over your life.
Yeah,
amen.
It took people moving out of place for Bree to show up that started working with praise and worship.
Yeah,
amen.
Amen. That's right.
Sometimes people are in the way.
Come on.
And God will allow them to shift and move out the way so that the right people can get in position to do what he has called them forth to do. Okay, read 14 and 18.
14 through 18.
Mm-hmm.
And they lift up their voice and wept again. And Orpha kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clave unto her. And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law is gone back unto her people.
Orpha what?
It's going back into her.
She left. It's showing you that sometimes when you're walking forth in purpose, everybody's not going to believe what God has called you to do.
Amen.
They will walk away.
Yeah.
They will walk away from you, and we'll take it personal.
Yeah.
But sometimes isolation does not necessarily mean that everybody was bad that was connected to us.
Right.
Sometimes they needed to isolate and walk away from us because they was in the way of the purpose that God has spoken over our lives.
Yeah.
There are some people right now that I can look back over and I said, God, where would they have fit right here now in my life?
Right.
They don't fit no more.
Mm-hmm.
You have to understand that every level, it gonna take a new set of people sometimes in order to get you to the place that God has spoken over your life.
Right.
You need people that's on your team that's gonna help push you.
That's right.
You remember the other Bible study? I went around the room. I said, "What you good at?
Mm-hmm.
What your gift is? You got to know what gift your team operating."
Right.
Because when it's time to go out to battle, I don't need for you to be able to run the ball and you can't run no faster than a 2-3.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, a 7-8. I need for somebody with some speed to be able to run the ball. I don't need nobody with rocks in their shoes. If you ain't got good hands, why we gonna throw you the ball? We need somebody that's gonna be able to catch the ball and ain't got butterfingers. You got to know the people that's on your team. Know them that labor amongst you.
Yes, yeah.
Orpha walked away because Orpha didn't see what was in Ruth worth following.
Yeah.
Everything that was tied to you died. So why am I going to follow behind you?
Yeah.
Am I next?
Right.
You know, because people tend to think that.
Yeah.
Oh, everybody up died. Child, you better not drunk over there. All of them over there dying. You might be next. And sometimes when people don't see the value in you, they'll run away from it. But Ruth said, I'm cleaving to you. Who is it that you know that's going to help you get to your destiny? In order to walk into the destiny that was on Ruth's life, she first had to push Naomi to go forward.
Yeah.
Ruth had to push Naomi forward.
Yeah.
I'm pushing Ruth because I didn't want to go. And Ruth kept saying, look at him.
Come on. Yeah.
When you going to start? I ain't going over to that church. I don't like going there. When you going to start? And sometimes people will push you. They be the roofs in your corner.
Yeah. Come on.
Say, I believe in you.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we'll waver.
Right. Come on.
And we'll stay in a place of doubt.
Come on.
I don't think that I can lead this. I don't think I'm good enough.
Right.
I don't think I speak eloquent enough.
My Lord.
I don't think I know the Bible like I. And they say, go. I believe in you. No, you ain't having no physical baby. You're going to have a spiritual baby. You're going to have a spiritual breakthrough.
Yeah.
It's lying on the inside of you. You're about to give birth to something.
Jesus.
You're about to give birth to something. And Naomi, I can't afford for you to die. Because this baby that you're about to give birth to,
yeah.
I can't go to this funeral. I can't watch this baby be aborted.
Come on.
Jeez. I can't go and go through another service.
Mm-hmm.
I can't read another obituary because what you got on the inside of you, I need for you to live.
Yes.
Because
yes.
By you living mean that I'm going to live.
Come on.
And so sometimes I need for somebody to push me.
Yes.
Push. I want you to push your neighbor. So what's in you?
What's in you?
Is worth following.
It's worth following.
Yes, it is.
There's greatness on the inside of you.
Amen.
There's power on the inside of you. There's anointing on the inside of you.
Yes.
There's some of you, y'all didn't even know what gifts y'all had until y'all started walking forth in divine destiny.
Come on.
Amen.
Because what's in you what's on me, but what's in you.
Yeah.
You didn't even know that you had a prayer life.
My God.
Now y'all pray for a whole 30 minutes.
Come on, somebody.
Sometimes even still have to cut y'all off. You have to know what's in you.
Yeah.
And even when you don't, you got to have somebody on your team say you got it.
Yeah.
I love the song, and I know it ain't no church song, but hey, you got it, girl. I like to listen to that song. Zion be in the back, she be bebopping off that thing. She tell my mom, turn that up. Because you got it.
Right.
But we sometimes need somebody to remind us we got it.
Yeah.
Because we get bitter at life.
Yeah.
It didn't go the way I thought.
That's true.
It didn't happen the way that I thought it was going to happen.
That's right.
I didn't give birth to it when I thought that I was.
Mm.
Enough people didn't follow me when I thought they was going to follow me. Mm-hmm. When I stepped out on faith, everybody left me standing on the curb by myself.
Jesus.
But sometimes God will send that one.
Mm-hmm.
That Ruth, that real friend. We all need some friends like Ruth.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
That's going to push you. If you ain't got no friend like Ruth, I'm telling y'all right now, you need to cut them off.
That's right.
You need to cut them off. Because in this next season in y'all lives, we in the middle of a pandemic. And you know why things are off? In the atmosphere, because God is shifting us to another level.
Yeah.
Come on.
He's shifting us to
Come
another
on.
Glory.
Yeah.
And we need people that's not only just in our circle, we need people that's also in our corner.
Come on.
They say, I'm going to help push you.
Yeah.
Because, see, I can't let you die right here. Because if you die in the middle of the pandemic, that means I might die.
Yeah.
Amen.
If you die, I might die. And I can't afford. I can't afford for you to die.
Yeah.
Imagine how many people that'll die if you didn't go forth in the thing that God has spoken over your life.
Amen.
There's some people right now on life support because they're waiting on y'all.
Jesus. My Lord.
They're waiting on spiritually on life support because they're waiting on y'all. I took Zion to get her hair braided the other day, and the young lady said to me, she said, please don't ever stop doing Daughters of Zion. It gives me life.
My Lord.
Wow.
I didn't even know she watched it.
My Lord.
Sometimes I walk in the store, and they be like, you the girl that be on Facebook Live. Your messages bless me. It get me through the day.
Stop signing in
and
watching me.
Yeah.
Be amazed. And we're sitting around crying over the spilled milk of what happened yesterday.
Wow.
And God said, I want to pour you another cup.
Come on now.
Come on,
God want to pour us another cup.
Yeah.
But we're crying over what happened.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying what happened didn't hurt you.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that you didn't cry. But after a while, you got to wipe your face and get up, Naomi.
Yeah.
You got ministry to do.
Yeah.
You got ministry to do.
Yes, come on.
Just imagine if she said, you know what, I'm going to die with my sons and my husband. Orpha walked away and left. And she said, you know what, Ruth? What if Ruth would have walked away?
Yeah.
I can't do this. I can't do it. But here come Ruth saying, I need for you to live not only for you.
Come on.
I need for you to live for me.
Yeah.
Because she said, where you go, I go. Your God gonna be my God. Where you lodge, I lodge. She let her know, I'm following you. I'm with you all the way.
Yeah.
Yes, there gonna be people walk away. Yes, you gonna run across some orphans. Whenever you're doing anything great,
yeah.
offers got to go. Because offers are revealed when you're moving.
Yes.
Watch the crowd just for a moment. And see if they still celebrating you when you begin to move. I saw somebody did a post. Friends are not supposed to be jealous. Friends supposed to be proud of you when you do something great.
That's right.
If you can't show up when I'm doing something great, I don't want you showing up when I'm going through.
Come on.
Because let me tell you, sometimes I need somebody to help pick me up.
Yes.
And if you got to laugh and talk about me when I'm going through, don't show up when I get on the mountaintop.
Yes. Come on.
Because you don't deserve to be up here in my mountaintop place when you couldn't go through the valley with me.
Come on.
Yes, now.
We need real friends.
Yeah.
Real friends. Real people to support you through this.
Yeah.
Walking forth in the thing that God has placed on the inside of you, you're going to need real people to show up and say, I got your back.
Yeah.
I believe in you.
Yeah.
Let's do this. Let's go together. One of my girlfriends, she tell me right now, she tell me, I don't live there, but whatever you're doing, I got your back.
Yeah.
Come on. That what you need?
Yeah.
I don't need for you to... Wait, were you silent? Because what you believe in, you invest in it.
That's right.
How many of y'all pay y'all tithes?
Amen.
Why? Because y'all believe in it.
Yeah.
You got to be mindful where you sow it.
That's right.
You go out there sowing seeds in an old dried up field and trying to figure out why things ain't growing up for you. You got to know, make sure where you planting your seeds at.
Yeah.
It's going to prosper. It's going to grow. Because I'll never be broke another day in my life. Never be. Even when Orpha left, Ruth stayed. And when she got back, and that's in the 19th verse.
Mm-hmm.
When she got back to where she was, everybody was looking at her saying, Naomi, is that you?
Mm-hmm.
When you get back to the thing and the place that God has spoken and declared over your life,
mm-hmm.
you ain't even going to look like what you've been through. That's a sad clap, y'all.
Dang.
You ain't even going to look like. You ain't even going to look like what you've been through. Walking forth in the thing that God has placed on the inside of you. You got to believe it. Receive it. And walk forth in it. Because what's in you is worth following. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
What's in you?
What's in you?
Is worth following.
Is worth following.
I'ma help you.
I'ma help you.
I'ma push you.
I'ma push you.
To walk in.
To walk in.
The thing. That God has spoken.
That God has spoken.
Over your life.
Over your life.
Clap your hands all around. I pray that this word has been a blessing to you. Join us back in just a few minutes and as we go forth in our gift class. Have an awesome and wonderful night.